Meanwhile, the Republican Party is picking through the wreckage of Mitt Romney's election loss, trying to figure out exactly what went wrong and who will stand in 2016. TEN's US Bureau correspondent Daniel Sutton is in Boston.
Well, a giant chill has hit Boston. The Republicans are packing up the party that never really got underway last night and examining what went so horribly wrong for them. Mitt Romney says he left everything on the field in this campaign. So how did he lose so badly? Well, demographics to start with. He retained his support when it came to the white vote in America, but frankly, America is becoming less white. Barack Obama scored 93% of the African-American vote and also romped home when it came to the Latino and the Asian vote, both growing categories. The number of youth voters was also up this year, and that didn't do Mitt Romney any favours at all. Is he likely to stand again? Probably not. He's had two tilts already, and this loss will batter and damage him quite badly. Where will the Republican Party look for in 2016? Well, Paul Ryan, his VP pick, is certainly a possibility. Also, Governor Christie from New Jersey, who's been in the headlines because of Superstorm Sandy. He's a possibility, and he's been speaking today.
I've lost elections, and I know how it feels, and it hurts. And I never run for president. So I can't imagine, after putting in the kind of effort that Governor Romney's put in over the years to run for president, how badly it hurts this morning for him to have come up short.
Now, the one silver lining for the Republicans in this election, they retain control of the House of Representatives. So now the question becomes, will they stifle a president's agenda now that he's won a second term? Well, the House Speaker John Boehner has also been speaking today. He says that he is willing to engage in bipartisanship, to talk to the president, even when it comes to tax reform, as long as the president is willing to cut spending to help America's struggling economy.
A very chilly day in Boston. Dan Sutton there for us.